Hello, I am Rajesh from MKU, and we are very happy to be here at the Defexpo 2020. It's been a different Defexpo in many ways. It's been the first time that it has been held in Lucknow, a place that is very close to our hearts since our manufacturing operation started from MKU Kanpur, and we are very closely associated with the government of India. It's been a different expo because the footfalls at this expo have been extremely good. We've had a number of foreign delegations who have visited us. There have been visits from the end users, both from India and from abroad. Visits by the Raksha Mantri himself and the CDS and many other leading dignitaries. It's also been very significant because in this Defexpo, we've been able to showcase many of our technologies which we have worked on tirelessly over the last several years. We have increased the range of our electro-optic devices. We have the range of image intensifier based and thermal imaging based equipment with us now. And we are also happy to say that today we are in a position to respond to most of the demands of the Indian forces. We are in a position to respond to their RFIs with our products. We've also made a significant announcement along with Thales, with whom we had signed an MOU at the last Defexpo. And this announcement that was made today, earlier in the day today, is for the co-development and manufacture of their device in our works in Kanpur. The significant part of this announcement and this agreement is that not only is this device going to be manufactured and offered to the Indian forces, it will also be there for the global market. We've had a very significant improvement in the way we have worked on the specifications which have been released by the government of India. We have now announced the BIS standards for body armor. This is relevant because in most of the cases earlier, the standards did not actually define a protocol for ammunitions which were being used here. And today we have been able to offer a vest which conforms to these standards. Another significant development has been the designing of comfort features which have been embedded into the body armor. Now, as the threats increase, so does the weight of the armor. And if that load level rests entirely on the shoulders, it becomes very difficult for the soldier on the ground to maneuver himself and to be very responsive. So what the feature that we have added on is the dynamic load distribution system, which is also a requisite of the BIS standards, which helps to take the load off the shoulder of the soldier, distribute it over his back and body, and as a result of which, makes him more flexible, more mobile, and makes the overall weight much more comfortable to carry. Why this is important is because the threats will keep changing, the threats will keep evolving. And as the threats increase, as the threats evolve, so will the armor that will provide protection. But how much weight can you keep adding onto the soldier's back? So what we have realized is that we need not just work on providing protection against the new threats that are emerging, but we also have to ensure that the team of engineers design a product by which this load can be taken off their shoulders. It is a fact that the loads will keep increasing, but if there is a way by which it can be distributed over the body so that the actual weight on the shoulder can be reduced, that is the way to move forward. And that is what our team of engineers is working on. We also have, in this particular Defexpo, demonstrated a new concept called NICS, which is the Network Centric Integrated Command System. weapons through which we are able to interconnect the various soldiers on the ground, not only amongst themselves, but also through the base, and which is a very important feature which going forward will prove to be very beneficial to the forces, especially when they are in operation where they are not in the sight of their comrades. It will also help in identifying the friend from the foe and ensure that people are not killed in friendly fire. These are just some of the new technologies that we have worked on, and as the show goes on, so does the challenge that is faced by our engineers, and so does the development of new technologies products, which will keep changing.